This is the process for atmospheric monitoring and when it's required for respirable crystalline silica. Atmospheric monitoring is commonly referred to as air monitoring. Respirable crystalline silica is a hazardous substance. The health impacts of exposure include silicosis, lung cancer, and autoimmune diseases such as scleroderma. Employers must ensure that their workers are not exposed to a concentration of a hazardous substance, such as respirable crystalline silica, above the relevant exposure standard. You can find exposure standards on the Safe Work Australia website. Exposure standards are generally set at the lowest airborne concentration that's unlikely to cause harm. Air monitoring enables employers to understand what level of respirable crystalline silica a worker is potentially breathing in. In order to compare a person's exposures against the exposure standard, measurements must be made in a person's breathing zone. Air monitoring involves an employee wearing a pump with an air sampling device attached and positioned in the worker's breathing zone. The sampling device has a small filter in it that captures the respirable dust. Monitoring should occur over the full shift, or at least the majority of it, so as to get a representative sample. The filter is then analysed by a lab. The results will then be interpreted to understand if a worker is likely to be exposed to a level of respirable crystalline silica above the exposure standard. Both the air monitoring and the interpretation of results needs to be done by a person who's adequately qualified and experienced, such as an occupational hygienist. Air monitoring is required if an employer is unsure if their workers are exposed to a level above the exposure standard. Air monitoring results need to be provided in a report that discusses when the monitoring took place and what work was observed to be happening on the day. The report should detail the systems of work, identify the sources of exposure, help determine if the controls in place are effective, and provide site-specific recommendations. Results must be provided to all workers who have been or are likely to be exposed to respirable crystalline silica. Routine air monitoring could form part of an employer's systems of work to confirm if controls are being maintained. In some situations, static monitoring may be conducted to help with evaluating the effectiveness of some controls. This is where the pump and the air sampling device are in a fixed location and not on a worker. The results from static monitoring can't be used to determine a worker's personal exposure. Real-time dust monitoring may also be used to help with evaluating the effectiveness of some controls. But these results also can't be used to understand a worker's personal exposure. A good place to find a suitably qualified person to undertake air monitoring is through the Australian Institute of Occupational Hygienists. For further information and guidance on air monitoring, visit the WorkSafe website.